the point is, you can only pay people with money, and you can only get money from being in business. And if your business is not open, there comes a point, and we can argue the toss over where that point should be, but you'd have to be an imbecile not to recognise that there comes a point where that equation falls apart, and you can't pay people because you ain't got any money because your business isn't open to make it.
Well, I mean, that's it, but from a personal point of view, you know, I've guys, girls working for me for 20 plus years. You know, I have a guy off at the minute. He met his partner, who also works for me. They're having their first child.
Nah, you're a good man.
They've got their first mortgage. They only moved in January, and you know, it's a harsh thing to say, I can't afford to pay you. You've given me so much.
No, well, I mean, you've already cast yourself in the annals of bosses people would like to have. There'll be plenty of people listening to this who have bosses considerably less concerned about their own welfare than you clearly are about your workforce. But and for anyone sort of poised to accuse you of overreacting or scaremongering, the front page of the best-selling newspaper in the country today, which may well be guilty of scaremongering itself, but I don't think so. Entire UK cities could be put into lockdown as the country battles to contain coronavirus. And it felt like it was happening almost in a different time zone when we first started speaking to our friend Luke, who was over in China and was describing an area not directly hit. It wasn't in Wuhan, but he was in Yantong. But he was describing it as being essentially a ghost town. And that is what you fear, is that your business, however successful it may be, your business depends upon traffic. It depends upon footfall. It depends upon people coming into your premises and spending money.
Well, I mean, that's it. And I was discussing this over the weekend with my wife, and I do think of a lot of it is irrational fear that worries me most. That you know, stuff will go into lockdown. You know, people will say you shouldn't visit shopping centres. I have one of my stores is actually inside a hospital.
Oh, blimey.
So that's a double whammy if the health service might quite easily say you need to close your store.
Because, right, or, I mean, not to make light of the situation, that could be a swings and roundabout scenario. You could be cleaning up in the one in the hospital while the other four go under. Just a joke. I'm just joking.
it's hard for people who are not in business to understand, well, why can't you continue to pay your staff? You have a profitable business. There comes a point that, three or four weeks of paying full pay with nothing coming back in, and I hope it doesn't